Good morning. So I will present some tools that we, together with Helmut Burkhardt, actually, we developed for the evaluation of the synchrotron radiation in the interaction region. And I will present some synchrotron radiation fans in the interaction region for the two lattices that Corazzino's just presented, and here just a list of some previous presentations, just to say that synchrotron radiation is a big concern for TLEP, but in addition there are also other background sources that need careful studies, and I will spend just a very few slides also on this. In fact, we have two main classes of background sources. It's very well known. Apart from synchrotron radiation, I also listed some beam particle effects, single beam and IP background. Both aspects have already been deeply studied for some past machines, but of course there are many novel issues that have to be taken into account with this with FCC, with this very high energy and challenging machine. So here just the main formulas for the synchrotron radiation, and here this just to say that magnetic fields of the order of 0.1 tesla, that is of the order of like was LEP2 and TLEP, we have a mean free path length of the order of 1 meter. So the synchrotron radiation cone distribution is mostly from the bending angle, plus a minor contribution from divergence of the order of 10 microrad with synchrotron radiation process. And here is the angular distribution at the critical energy is of the order of, has been evaluated, so it's of the order of 3 microrad for TLEP. So here is just a picture of the photon spectrum, power spectrum. Of course, all these evaluations have to be done for the synchrotron radiation. So spectrum and absorption, this is very important, and we see here that with the typical mean photon energies, now we are at about with LEP2, as we are in the same order with TLEP that was with LEP2, we are of the order of 350 kV, that is very very high and difficult to collimate. It is of the same order of LEP2, but here we have an enormous photon flux and megawatt of power. So this seems really too much. So the aim is that we do not have to generate hard synchrotron radiation anywhere close to the interaction region, as this is a very dangerous, a very high critical energy. So the approach that we have been using for FCC-EE challenge is that, of course, the key points are that we want the bands in the interaction region that are as weak as possible and as far as possible from the interaction point, and the quadrupoles have to be strong and close to the IP to minimize the offset from the quad axis and careful vertical halo tails. So for this, synchrotron radiation Monte Carlo has been implemented and integrated in GEANT. So we started developing the software tools to be ready when the optics was ready to evaluate this synchrotron radiation. This is just a picture from Mike Sullivan last X Factory workshop in Beijing is a very clear picture that shows that the synchrotron radiation from the last vertical focusing magnet can be usually shielded from the IP detector beam pipe. But this is more difficult when the photons penetrate from the beam pipe. On the other hand, the synchrotron radiation from the last horizontal focusing magnet is more difficult to block because the beam is overfocused, and then in order to compensate the focus. So, of course, this is, let's say, the principle that has to be taken into account when designing the interaction region. So, the generic tool for interaction region studies, which we call them the ICIM, reads the MADX lattice and survey, also with apertures if available. And then it is the MADX lattice is read by root with the main geometry interface tool, and then in this way we calculate the synchrotron radiation fans and the parameters. So the step one is to construct tables with detailed information and transformation of Kuhn-Snyder machine coordinates to Euclidean detector coordinates. Step two is that the geometry is displaced based on the MADX aperture information using the event visualization environment, and then the accelerator tracking. So here is an example of how the geometry has been imported. This is the kind of plot that we produce. So this is the possibility of importing the geometry into Giant for detailed full simulations. Of course, there are. This tool can be used also for the FCCHH machine, and here is an example where we have seen that the critical energy is only 5 keV. But okay, just an example to say that there is, of course, a close synergy with the HH machine. Now, just two plots showing how this tool works. This is the interaction region by Anton. Of course, this is what Mike said in the previous talk was said to be the old lattice. Of course, our calculations come after that the lattice is done. So we will, now that the new lattice is ready, we will update these calculations. Anyway, this is the first, the December, let's say, last December Crabwaves optics. And these are the evaluations with the MDI SIM tool. In red are the energy over 100 keV within 200 meters from the interaction point. These are the bands, and these for the quadrupoles at 1 sigma horizontal. So you see that with respect to our previous presentation, we added also the calculation of the power of the synchrotron power, while at first it was only the mean energy. So you can see that this is very high, and the power also was very high. And in fact, Anton got this message, and this is starting from this he produced a new lattice, and we will see how it works. So this slide already has been shown, the trajectory is at the IP the horizontal and the machine, and this how are the synchrotron radiation band cones look like starting from the IP. You have seen this already, showing how the synchrotron fans actually this is the starting point from which work has to be done on the lattice. And the Crabwaves optics has been compared to the CERN one, that is a more conventional one. And here you see that only the first dipole has a critical mean energies that is above 100 keV, and this was looked actually better from the synchrotron radiation point of view. And in fact, these are the cones, the synchrotron radiation cones. Anyway, the concerns from the MDI point of view, once that we evaluated the synchrotron radiation fans, of course, is the compatibility of the state clear apertures with effective masking of incoming synchrotron radiation. We have to take into account the edge scattering from the upstream synchrotron radiation masks, back scattering from the downstream aperture limitations. So now, just before conclusion, I have three slides on the other important background sources that are single beam effects and IP backgrounds. In blue, what is in blue is the loss particles dependent on momentum acceptance. In particular, beam straddling is strongly dependent on momentum acceptance. And in fact, here is a slide showing different dependence on the energy acceptance, where you see that, for example, the cross section as a function of the delta E over E is not very much dependent for the radiative bubble, while for beam straddling, this is for Tushek, this is very much dependent. Of course, Tushek is very important in low emittance machines, but also with not very high energy, while beam straddling high energy is a main issue. Of course, all these effects have to be studied and tracked and taken into account. This is just to say how important is the momentum aperture for the beam loss effect. In fact, it is crucial for all sources inducing a delta E over E, as I said, like Tushek, radiative bubble, beam straddling at high energy, and it is best determined with full tracking. This is an example of how the Monte Carlo for the Tushek effect works, where we have for each longitudinal position not only the delta E over E, but also the loss probability. And this is in order to, so it's not just an S-dependent momentum aperture like the plots on the right side. And this is to say that we need this kind of careful tracking to do really a full simulation, and not only to do lifetime evaluation, but also loss, beam loss, particle losses at AP simulation. Okay, this is also to say that also pair production is important, has to be studied carefully. It can be studied with guinea pig generation, and can be high production rate, but particles have low energy and loop in the solenoidal field. So is it, of course, we have to understand for which subsystem is relevant. Typically, low energy Carling, E plus E minus, is relevant for vertex detector and first layers of tracking devices. So full simulation with GM4 is needed, and okay, same statements are valid for MOM production to be checked at this energy. So I come to my conclusion. Synchrotron radiation in the interaction region is a major issue for TLEP at top energy. Photon energy is very similar to LEP2, where this was acceptable with interaction regions designed for low synchrotron radiation, and there were about 100 collimators. But the luminosity was much lower, so of course we didn't have the high power that we expect now. So the work for TLEP only started, much more to do, not only on interaction region synchrotron radiation, but also on beam particle effects. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Manuela. Very nice results. Questions?
I have one question, maybe for Mike, but the beam is crossing at this angle, and why does it go like this? You know, why do we have a this triple bend structure rather than just directly like that. Yeah, it's a horizontal plane, yes.
You saw the design, the latest design does not have that, so this was really addressed. The design is, yeah, so if you put the next one, which where we can see the on the Y plane there, if you remember, the new design only has one bend. It does not have this.
And it goes straight here, I think.
Yeah.
It depends on the quadruple setting here. We should
have a look at my talk, and you'll see that the new design is very rational.
Okay. Of course, we will update also this synchrotron radiation evaluation with the new optics.
So, what is? Do you have the total power synchrotron radiation lost in the in this design?
So the total power should be this one from 57 megawatt. Anyway, the because we have the power
megawatt.
Yeah.
What?
But I'm not sure about this number. I must say that we were still with Helmut. We were still. We needed some check. If it should be anyway. These are correct. So this is. I'm not sure. I think this is not because this is 33 kilowatt. The first one already. So in the first bands. So I'm not sure that this is the sum. No. In fact, I must say that me too. I saw this. I said, okay, I have to check. Yeah, so.
I have a question on your last statement. You said the synchrotron radiation is similar to that of LEP2, but we have a much larger luminosity. However, this larger luminosity, which is about a factor 100 larger at the top, is distributed also over 100 bunches. So at the IP, it must be exactly the same for each bunch. What do you think? For each crossing, you have about the same amount of synchrotron radiation as at LEP2, or is it a wrong impression?
No, okay, it's true, but the emittance also, I mean, the beam is much more focused at IP.
Right.
So this could make the difference also, I mean.
It's not included in what you evaluated. So
this effect is not included in.
Comment?
Why, if the beam has a different, a smaller emittance, it radiates more? No, each electron does not know about the others. I mean, the radiation inside the magnetic field doesn't depend if you put the electron like that or like that.
No, but you focus
it. I would say you focus.
Okay.
Yeah, in the quadrupoles also, I don't think that in LEP you had synchrotron radiation from quadrupoles or.
So this is a question for the next
person.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, but the capability to focus on a smaller cross section depends on the property of the beam, not on the fact that you put a much stronger quadrupole. If you have to focus, I mean, you are discussing how to go from here to there, and the difference on the lever arm doesn't change so much. So I don't see the classical effect that makes the radiation depends on the luminosity, but okay.
You have a beam at the same distance as at LEP2, which is as large as at LEP2, and you have to make it much more focused. So yes, you are making some synchrotron radiation there from the focusing quadrupole. Look, the expert is here, she will think of it.
Okay.
Other questions or comments? If not, thank you.
Thank you.
Again. Okay.